call them elementals, call them toads. I just like to call them a major pain in the actuators. Today's spotlight is all about the clan's armored infantry, the elemental battle armor. Clan Elemental Battle Armor has been a mainstay in the clan's arsenal since its introduction in 2868 by Clan Wolf. In its initial debut, it was used against Clan Novacat in a Trial of Possession. For those that aren't familiar with the Trial of Possession, it's a way for an honor-bound clan warrior to claim resources from a rival faction while minimalizing any collateral damage. According to legend, Clan Wolf used two stars of its new battle armor and thoroughly trashed a single star of light mechs from Clan Novacat. After word quickly spread of how effective these battle suits were, various deals and bargains were made with the other clans. I would guess by the end of 2868, the elemental was the must-have gift for all the good little crusaders and wardens.
Oh my god, it's elemental battle armor. Oh my god.
The elementals as they are presented in both the ill-fated Battletech cartoon, the novels, and sourcebooks show them to be effective killing machines. Something to fear, something not to ignore. And if you were in the Inner Sphere in 3050, something to figure out how to kill effectively and quickly. What we have here are the new plastic miniatures from the Clan Invasion box set. In the starter box, you get two stands of these feisty little murder ticks. But you can also snag a full star of five elemental stands in the standalone box set. Elemental miniatures are also available in metal thanks to Iron Wind Metals. Although the sizes and poses are different between both the plastic and the metal miniatures. In Alpha Strike, the elemental can be a real pain. With a jump movement of 6 inches, it gives the elementals a lot of wiggle room for maneuverability. With a damage bracket of 2 at short range and 1 at medium, it can do modest damage, but don't forget with the ability to jump around like a madman, you can easily get into your target's rear arc for increased damage opportunities. As for special abilities, let's start with the anti-mech ability. Infantry units with the anti-mech ability can make a special attack against any ground units, landed VTOLs, or grounded aerospace fighters, if they are in base-to-base contact. Anti-mech attacks are treated like a normal physical attack. A unit with the cargo ability can be carried by a unit with the infantry transport ability. However, you can only be carried if the transport has sufficient space to do so. For example, a cargo 5 unit would need a infantry transport of 5 to carry it. And finally, mechanized. Battle armor with this ability may hitch an Uber ride on any ground unit that has the Omni special ability. A particularly deadly pairing is with the Epona Pursuit Tank. Move 18 inches with the tank, hop off for another 6 inches in any which way you want. That could be towards an objective, provide some fire support, or just ruin your opponent's day. I speak about this from experience. In classic Battletech, the elementals are potentially just as nasty. Especially if a whole star of elementals descend upon a lone battle mech that's either cut off from its lance mates, or that overeager scout who dared to fly too close to the sun. I chose to paint these elementals as Clan Diamond Shark from Sigma Galaxy. If we had to place them in a specific unit, like a cannon unit, we could say they hail from the 8th Cruiser Cluster. With the exception of the base, these are entirely painted with Citadel contrast paints. I wanted to see if I could get decent results on these little fellas without painting them in a traditional manner. At the end of the day, they look good close up, and they look great at table length, which is more than enough for me. I do want to comment on the sculpts that Catalyst Game Labs was able to achieve here. While the detail is very nice, a few of my elementals do have slight defects. Nothing is a huge deal breaker here though. I'm more than okay with accepting small errors on these 6mm game pieces, especially since it's Catalyst Game Lab's first try at something so small in plastic. If you're a clan player, the elemental battle armor is a deadly tool in your arsenal, one that can wrest control of objectives from lesser infantry and ground units, or give their bigger cousins, the battle mechs, a really bad day on the battlefield. Hey all, if you're a fan of the channel, or liked what you saw, please hit that subscribe button and tell a friend about the channel. Sharing is caring, after all. See you folks on the next one.